We are now going to try to solve a problem using functions to print star signs or something called as asterisks on a computer screen. So let's first try to take a look at what the problem says. The problem says that it will give you a total number of stars to print. For example, it may say you are required to print 24 stars. But then it may also impose a condition saying that at the most you need to print 7 stars on each line. So if there are 24 stars in total, here I print 7, next line I print 7, third line I print 7, and last line I have to only print 3, because out of 24 only 3 are remaining. The other thing is, all these stars or the asterisks should be printed one at a time. So what I am going to do here is, I am going to solve this particular problem using functions. So first thing what I do is, I declare a variable called as short total. This holds the number, in our case 24, that is the total number of stars to be printed. And 7 is a variable called as short per line, which indicates how many star symbols are to be printed per line. So I'm going to ask the user enter the total number of stars and the number of stars per line. So I'm going to read the total number in the variable total and the number of stars per line in the variable called as per line. So what I need to do is, I need to declare prototype of this function called as print asterisk. So what this print asterisk is going to do is, print asterisk asterisks, it is accepting two data types of the type short. So what this is telling is, it's informing the compiler, I have a function called as print asterisks with two variables which happen to be short data types. That's what I am required to specify in this signature or function prototype declaration. I can also give the name short x, short y, that's fine. Okay, that's also perfectly fine, it'll accept it. Now what we'll do is, we'll try to write code for this particular function called as print asterisk. Okay, so this is a void function, not taking in any value. Then what I am going to do is, I am going to declare an integer, sorry, a short variable called as total. Now this total is not the same as the total in the main. This variable total and per line is local to the function print asterisks. Okay, so here it is. Now what I am going to do is, I'll take two variables I and j. You will soon understand their purpose. Alright. So what I am going to do with I is, I am simply going to start the for loop. I am going to say for long, as long as I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to the total number of star signs. Okay. Increase the value of I once every time after you print one star. And here you go ahead and print the star. Okay, we'll say you go ahead and print the star sign. Okay, so far so good, we print the star sign. But then we have a problem. Every time we print a star sign, I am also going to increase the value of another variable called as j. So why j is used is, j is used to count the number of stars printed per line. If the value of j, okay, if the value of j happens to be equal to the number of stars that are to be printed per line, then what I have to do is, I have to print the blank line so that I go to the next line. And along with that, what I need to do is, I need to see that j is initialized back to 0. So for the next line, again it begins to count from 0. Now what we'll try to do is, we'll try to copy, take this particular program and put it into the online GDB compiler, and let's try to see if it runs. Okay, and first, before running, let's hope it compiles. So here I'm simply going to paste this particular piece of code. Once I paste this particular piece of code, okay, Here, what I am going to do when I paste this particular piece of code is I am going to put this entire thing in comments. Once I compile and run it, I'll re-explain the logic so that you really understand how this program is going to really work. Okay, so this is the prototype of print asterisk, which is accepting two data types of short. So this indicates the total number of stars. This indicates the stars per line. The user is going to enter the total number of stars and the star per line. That values are going to be passed to print asterisk. So 24 is total and 7 is per line. This variable and this variable are not the same. They are in two different memory locations. This total is local to print asterisk. This total is local to main. We can verify that by printing the addresses of this total here and this total here. Now what I have done is I have taken a variable I and j. I will keep track of the total number of star symbols printed. So I'm starting I from 1. As long as I is less than or equal to the total number of stars to be printed, I am going to print a star at a time. But every star I print, I am also going to keep track of the number of stars printed per line using another variable called as j. The minute j is equal to the number of stars to be printed per line, I am going to go to the next line using the backslash n. And be sure you make this back to 0. This is something students tend to forget at the beginning. So let's compile this and see where things stand. In order to make it easy, I'll just enter a very small value of total. So let me say I'm interested to just enter print 8 stars and just 3 stars per line. So it should print 3, 3 and 2. So here if you see, it's really done what we were expecting it to do. It has printed 3 stars on one line, 3 stars on the second line and 2 stars on the last line for a total of 8 stars. Because I had indicated I want to print 8 stars, so it printed 8 stars, but it printed only 3 per line. So what I would suggest is take some sample data values like 10, 20, 30, run through the code. The key idea is here. This for block is simply going to print the total number of stars. But after the required number of stars are printed per line, I should see that after printing 3 stars, I should go to the next line. And be sure this count j is back to 0 so that again I can start counting whether 3 stars are printed on the next line and so on. Now one thing I told you, I wanted to show you the total, the address of total in main is going to be different from the address of total in this thing. So let's experiment with that. So we are going to say percentage u, okay, is address of total in main, all right. So what I am going to do here is I am going to say address of total, all right. And then, so this way you will know that there are two different variables. They just happen to have the same names because one is local to main and one is local to print asterisk. So let me take this print asterisk and copy and paste it here. All right. So let me paste it here. The spelling of address. Okay. I'm not going to worry too much about. We'll just comment out this print asterisk so that it doesn't run that particular piece of code. It just shows us the value of the address. Oh sorry, if I don't call print asterisk, it's not going to print the other total. So anyway, fine. So let's try to compile it and see everything is fine. Okay, that's fine. So we will, that warning for now we'll ignore, but let's try to enter something. Let's enter 5 stars, 3 per line. Okay, so here if you see the address of total in print asterisk is 207. I'll make it a little more clear, is 207971036, whereas the address of total in main is 207971084. This clearly indicates that total in main is very different from the total in print asterisk. So you need to understand, this is the actual parameters, these are the actual parameters, these are the formal parameters. Okay, so these are different copies from these.